A14, one of the most iconic structures on the 127-mile A14 route, is the feature that I'm just coming up to. And of course, it's the Orwell Bridge. Driving over the bridge seems like going over any viaduct on a major highway, and gives very little idea of how large the bridge actually is and how high it rises over the Orwell. The walls have been set high enough so that people can't crawl along in their cars admiring the view. It's only when we view the bridge from underneath do we get some idea that it's a significant structure. In fact, the central span of the bridge at 190 metres was the largest concrete box girder structure in Europe at the time it was finished in 1982. The bridge itself is 1,287 metres long and is actually two bridges, side by side. Underneath you can see the gap between them. They're made from concrete box girders, effectively two long tubes made from steel reinforced concrete, which are balanced on bearings on top of each of the piers to allow it to move as the bridge expands and contracts. Because the box girders are hollow, it means that services such as the water main from Alton Water can be routed under the roadway, as well as power lines and telecommunications. The bridge design was complicated by the need to make it high enough for ships to pass underneath, but not so high that it would make traffic too vulnerable to winds. Another complication for the builders was that the bridge deck needed to be curved at one end, which was at the time complicated for the size of box girder being used. We take the bridge for granted these days, but at the time it was viewed as a marvel of modern engineering. It doesn't have the impressive looking cabling of the Humber Bridge or the sheer size of the Meaux Viaduct in France, but the simplicity of design of the Orwell Bridge actually belies that at the time of its construction, it was cutting-edge technology. That said, a structure of this type is costly to maintain, currently around about £500,000 a year, and it has to be thoroughly inspected every 5 to 6 years. Then, every 25 years, the bearings on top of the piers need to be replaced, and this has recently been done. From a highway's point of view, the Orwell Bridge was the preferred solution to bypass Ipswich, as it would connect the A45 best with the A12 and Ipswich docks. So it's impressive, and one of the premier landmark structures in Suffolk. It's fully accessible to pedestrians, who can walk across and stop to admire the superb view from the top. If you don't want to walk it, there are some great pictures on Google Street View. But this structure has also gained a more sinister reputation, and the signs at the bottom of the steps up give us a clue. The significance is only made really clear when you get up to the start of the bridge walk, as there are free phones to the Samaritans. The Orwell Bridge has gained itself some notoriety for suicides. This is in common with most high bridges, and there are a few each year. Everyone is a tragedy. A tragedy for the person who jumps, but also for the loved ones who have to come to terms with their death. What I can't understand is why access for pedestrians hasn't been limited. It easily could be, and the footways here aren't exactly a very pleasant walk anyway, being so close to the traffic. I rarely see anyone walking on it, and apparently the police may challenge anyone they see up here just in case. In fact, they now have cameras on either end to monitor the bridge. The death of someone who takes their own life is tragic, as God never intended the human race to end their lives by their own hand. If you're someone who's finding life difficult and are thinking suicidally, then I'd urge you to find help. If you don't have anyone, the Samaritans are always there for you and will listen and try to help. There are some numbers on the MRBC website of other sources of assistance as well. Maybe you're someone who has been touched by the suicide of a family member or friend. You know how traumatic losing somebody in this way is. I've also put some addresses of national and local organisations who can help you. And again, they're on the MRBC website. If you're someone who just like prayer, then please get in touch. And We'll try to connect you with somebody locally who'll pray with you. I know a few people who don't like going over the Orwell Bridge because of its association with tragic deaths. But we can also view the bridge in a very different way. It's a testament to people's ingenuity and creativity to build a structure that fires the imagination. And also, as we look at the landscape, we're inspired by the natural world as well. It shows us a little of the beauty of life and the potential of life as well. It reminds me of some words of Jesus when he said, "I've come in order that you might have life, life to the full." That's what God's desire is for us. And that's what our desire should be for ourselves. Well, thanks for listening and God bless you.